Good afternoon, one and all. As like Mr. Puneet has said, that I had to rush into Patiala for some work. But as they say that for a career planning or a strategy planning, first and the foremost is that what you do is a commitment. I am reminded of Salman Khan's movie dialogue. Agar commitment kar di to fir main apne aap ki bhi nahi sunta. So in the same way, if you have to succeed and make success, you have to have career planning only starts if you begin. It says what is the best way to move in life is to think first. And then they say what is true if you have thought. They say if you have thought, put it into action. And then if they say action and words ultimately culminate into your storyline. And what I often say on this platform and other platforms also, career planning strategies all are derived from the word habit. And habit means first it is it, then bit, then a bit, then habit. Once you start cultivating the habits which are required for any good things, even I would say a bad habit also doesn't cultivate immediately. Gradually and gradually, if you don't get out, the habits make you bad. But if you start planning, that's what we are here with Dr. K. Siddhartha, a famous strategist and a famous advisor to not only at national level and international level, national would be to various states, etc. After having been in contact with Dr. K. Siddhartha, though of course the bridge between both of us was Professor Puneet Sharma, who has been a connecting point to large number of people. And as they say, a friend is known by a company he keeps, just like they say that the birds of same flock fly together. So once I found that Mr. Puneet is coming across with a lot of people, and then we had a common idea, why not promote something which is good for the society, especially during these testing times. And when we say we were all going at a faster speed, but because of this COVID-19, it gave us a time to relook, revisit and move forward. On these broader contours of the topic, career planning and security actions for 21st century. Amongst us, we have Dr. K. Siddhartha, as I said, strategic thinker, perception, management consultant. And at the same time, amongst us, though Dr. Puneet, Professor Puneet, who is a dean as well as a anchor of the Doordarshan. I would also say that he's also a good planner who can help to plan things in the right way. And they say, when you conceive an idea, akele chale the aur bheed judti gayi aur karwa ban gaya. And same is, as we see today, we are on the 251st webinar and more than 7,500 subscribers on the YouTube, that people are showering love and goodwill amongst us, which helps us to motivate better and do better. And I will ask Mr. Puneet to take over. And meanwhile, I think within 10 or 15 minutes, I will be reaching at my place. Over to you, Puneet, take over. And I know that the one is alone and two is a company. And one, there is two company, and you don't feel that once I join you, they don't say that it's a crowd, but I would say that it's towards a much better, happy place where we'll be sharing our knowledge. Over to you, Puneet. And thank you. I will be long with the 10 minutes.
Energetic start and putting up right vibrations, Vikasji. And I'm sure in the coming 15, 20 minutes, you will be with us. So coming to Dr. K. Siddharth, I mean, it is always a pleasure to interact with you. Earlier also, I mean, I think 15, 20 days back, or I think a month's time back, we interacted on the same platform. When it comes to career planning, it is a continuous process of setting individual professional goals, exploring ways to achieve them through self and market evaluation and continuous learning. Comes to evaluation, could you please throw some light on the present situation in the context of Indian youth and 21st century?
Thank you, Puneetji. It is always a pleasure, more pleasure for me, because since I have interacted, I have been an ardent fan of you. And it's like that, I am fond of you, as simple as that. So talking to you in a conversation is always going to bring out the best in me. Coming to your question, 21st century is going to be a very different century for the Indian youth. the youth, one of those biggest problems and biggest issues is that the youth do not know that they are being programmed. Programmed means that they are made to think in the manner that anyone can go to make them think. It's not that they can go to think independently in that manner. They are inclined to think in the same manner as one can go to make them think, be it through media, be it through social media, or be it even through schools as well. And the reflection of it is going to be in the rigid mindset of most of the people. Now, the problem in this case is that if you are going to be programmed, then you're always going to be replaced by a new program, by a new generation, and by a new skill. That means the present youth and its actions are very, very, very much replaceable. And also that they can be inflicted with viruses, and these viruses can go to be, if they are uncivilized, that's a virus because that goes, that is infectious, that can go to move. Short-term thinker is going to be a virus. Slave mentality, colonial mentality is going to be a virus. Being reactionary and judgmental is going to be another virus. And when they go on to think that they are moving, they are static movers. It's like they're going to keep on rocking in the same place without being actually productive and without being actually moving forward. The second problem that they're going to be facing is that is preserving their identity. Most of them go on to look for getting themselves fixed in some place. If you're going to ask them, who are you? Not what's your name? Who are you? Then they're not able to differentiate how to introduce them and how to introduce their name. Name introduction is easy, but then they can't go to introduce their personality. A large number of people in this century are already in the rat race, and preserving that identity is a big, big, big problem. Now, under such a condition, a slight spark can go to make anyone famous, can go to make anyone known, but at the same time, they're going to fade as easily as well. There will be more number of people who will be mechanical because human beings are now made into something like robots. And they are going to be poker-faced people like the one that you're going to see in China. That is devoid of any expression and nothing. They will be just like robots. They will be just like, they are just behaving like robots because they do not go on to build social capital so easily. For them, it is very, very difficult to build social capital, largely because they cannot go on to build so much amount of a trust. Trust building requires some amount of patience and some amount of investment of emotion in these aspects as well. Now, having said that, we'll also go on to point out the fact that there will be new type of problems. There will be new unknown problems as well. And some of these problems are going to be associated with perception wars, like a misinformation war. That is like something like a fake news that you're going to know. It will be a perception war. You're going to know that you know something, but you know that you know nothing at all about this topic completely. But then the redeeming point is that India will be more Indian, and there will be no place for people who are going to be judgmental, no place for them at all, absolutely, in this case. This is the issue that the youth is going to be confronted with, and that is a challenge to prepare themselves to tide over these deficiencies as well as prepare themselves for the next century.
Thank you, Dr. Sath. Rightly said that we should not program our mind to become judgmental. But biggest problem is how to prevent it. So that is a big challenge. People do not want to be judgmental, or they do not want to be build their perception for a particular thing and get biased towards it. But the bigger challenge is how to prevent this kind of exercise.
Well, when you're going to talk about it, how to prevent it, you have to know how is it that India is going to place you. It is going to be only talking about it. In order to prevent it, you have to understand the state of India and the world, whole of it. Only then you can go to say that I will be preventing myself from this state. Now, India will be more Indian in the coming future, in the coming century of sorts. This is largely because the type of civilizational assertion that you're going to see in India, people have started identifying themselves. People have started identifying their Sanatan Dharma as well. People have started identifying what India was. People have started coming to know the truth about history that has been unraveled, that has not been known to them deliberately. people also going to know that is what has been all the falsehood that they have been living in this case. Now, that is going to be one part. But then in the coming future, there'll be no place for judgmental people at all. Economy will also not going to be bad in the country, largely because the type of policy that we're going to be seeking right now, that is earlier we used to be having thinking that was of 19th century, that was pre-independence, that was the British type of a thinking. But now our thinking is completely being molded to get ourselves ready for the next century. Unless you're going to change it, there'll be no way that we can go to take advantage of in this case. Of course, we'll go to move towards a gig economy. That is a new type of economy completely where everyone will be a brand. And that is going to be the India in the coming next 20, 30 years of time, maybe 5-10 years of time as well. There'll be a greater amount of knowledge integration. Knowledge will go to play a much better role. Respectability will be a much bigger brand in comparison to that of popularity. And we always will go on to talk of that is when you're going to meet someone, what type of experience that you're going to give it to someone so that we start living in experiential economy. And the last part is that there'll be a greater adaptation to disasters because we are moving into a territory where we don't know perception warfare is going to take place, which new type of a COVID is going to be unleashing itself on us by our neighbors. Under such a condition, when we go on to be going through a fluctuating conditions of the economy, of the society, of the thinking, people will always going to think of readapting themselves. People will always going to think of transitioning themselves. So career transitioning will go on to become very, very, very significant in this case. So having talked about this condition of India, we can always going to say that is the conditioning that is going to be required right now will be career will be much more independent right now. That is the greater the amount of independence that you're going to have and the greater the amount of independence that you're going to ooze in your work, that will be what will be your career. Without independence, there cannot be a career. Career will be a new identity of the people. That is, everyone will go on to seek their own identity. Some of them can go on to be buffoons as well, but they'll be known as a different categories of buffoons as well. There'll be people also, and you will go on to know that there'll be not only one group of teachers, there will not be all teachers, there'll be mentors, there will be teachers, there'll be trainers, there'll be coaches, there'll be gurus, and there will be thought leadership trainers, and so on. So teachers are also going to be classified. The preachers are also going to be classified. Is most of the people will have to have a very high degree of self-understanding for themselves. Because without a self-understanding, they cannot go to use their talent. They cannot go to maximize their talent as well. And they cannot go on to give the type of a service that the new type of society will go to require. And of course, they will have to constantly go for reinventing themselves. Reinventing so much so that if they go on to reinvent themselves, they come to a new type of a career and think that now we can go to pick up another type of a career. So career transitioning will go on to become very, very significant. And most of the people will go to hop from one career to another so that they can go to enjoy the diversity of life, the entire trails of life, and the new type of a thinking that will go on to become pervasive during their time. They'll adapt, readapt, and then go on to move ahead in this case.
Rightly said. So if you are failing to prepare, it means you are preparing to fail. Rightly said by great Benjamin Franklin. So coming to the next question, is it possible to choose or build a career of self-choice? And the meaning of what will be the meaning of career in 21st century?
See, when you're going to talk about career security, essentially, you have to have certain type of characteristic that will go on to allow you to have so many dimensions of thinking, so many different type of adaptations that you can go on to have. Now, one of the most important component in this case will be, unless you go on to have a very clear cut communication, there will be no way that you can go on to build a career. It's simply not possible in the coming years. Largely because anyone who goes into think that they're going to mix English with Hindi, English with Tamil, Telugu and everything, or any of these languages, five languages going to mix and doesn't go to give any clear expression, then that is no way that you can and go on to think of moving ahead in this case, communication has to be key. That is one of the traits that you're going to require to have. The second trait is going to be, you cannot go on to be judgmental, opinionated, and you can't go on to be reactionary. That means you must be having an ability to balance your perception. Unless you're going to balance your perception, you will not be able to differentiate your emotions. For example, maybe that you cannot go to club all the politicians together. For example, there will be always a development politician, electoral politician, an intellectual politics, a drawing room politician, a communication politician, and maybe an international politician as well. So electoral type politics will be drawing room politics type. It is not going to be the same at all. Good number of people will go on to have, what they will require to go to design thinking, vertical thinking as well at the same time. Unless these people, I mean, most of these students, most of these youth, build knowledge, manage knowledge, fuse technology with knowledge, as we're going to say, design with nature, plan with technology, or plan with technology, design with nature. Whichever way that you have to go for, you have to take into account that the environment is not going to be static in the coming times at all. And good number of people have to be learners. That means you have to shed books only for the purpose and sole aim of learning. Largely because books cannot go to help you learn it only. You have to learn by communication. You have to learn by watching television. You have to learn also by eliminating some forms of social media news and so on and so forth. You have to be having open-minded in this case. And you require, definitely require, to gather local wisdom, use local wisdom, and integrate imagination with language. Unless you are able to integrate imagination with language, there is absolutely no way that you can actually go for career security. Career security will require that you go on to have these traits. And once you're going to be having these type of traits, then you can always go to shift from one end to another. You can always go to pick and choose. Now, this is what exactly that I'll go to pick up, because you're going to have a very high degree of self-understanding. You'll be balanced in sense of a perception management. And also that you can go to visualize things. You can go to learn from anything possible and everything possible. Career security is a concept that unless a person imbibes himself by training himself in all these aspects, they cannot go to make their career secure at all.
Right. So since change is a permanent thing now and for tomorrow as well, so transitions are inevitable, and as of now they are happening, and in future also it will occur. So how to cope up with this career transitions, and what are the charm and what are the problems?
See, there are three questions: how to cope up with career transitioning. Second is what is the charm, and what are the problems, challenges associated with it. Now, coming to the first part of it, that is career transitioning. Career transitioning will be essential and it will be required in the 21st century, largely because you cannot always go to remain in a single job. You cannot go to remain doing the same thing because monotony will be very, very high. We do not go to, let's accept this, Puniji. We do not go to live in a world where we can go to interact with nature, where we're going to be having a large number of people with whom we can go to hobnob easily. Will be mostly focused in our houses, mostly focused in our workplace. And we're going to be having a very narrow range of people through which whom we can go to be interacting as a human being, not as a professional, right? So career transitioning in this case will be difficult proposition, largely because you will always go on to try to diversify yourself because of the monotony that you go to set in. That is also a challenge, and that will be required as well. It will be required as well. Career transition will be also essential because the type of adaptations that the human being will require to have in response to the changing circumstances, changing environment, changing geopolitical conditions will be very, very different. For example, you require a different type of a mold and a personality to deal with some poker-faced Chinese. You will require a different type of a personality to deal with Americans. We'll require a different type of personality to deal with someone like Mr. Trudeau, who for no rhyme or reason poked into the internal affairs of another country of sorts. And of course, the people who can go to be looking for it. The charm of career transitioning is that you are a king. You are a king. You are independent. You are free. You can go on to unleash your powers of talent. You can go on to unleash your powers of expression and all the type of skills that you can go on to have. And you will go on to be enjoying yourself. Unless you're going to enjoy your career, unless you're going to enjoy your mindset, unless you're going to enjoy your thinking, there is no way that you can go to make a progress. Progress will be synonymous to career transitioning because you are fed up with being a bureaucrat. You're going to become a teacher. After 5 years of being a teacher, you're going to become an anchor like you. Then after having been anchor, you may go on to think of a liaising between different people also, governments, people. Now that will be a different type of a concept. Then you can go on to go for brand management of some people as well, brand management of a larger chunk of people also. Now that is why, how exactly you'll keep on getting insights and keep on getting a chance. But then the challenge in this case is that for every 5 or 6 years, maybe 7 years of a time, you require to adapt yourself. You require to learn yourself. You require to reinvent yourself. You require to reposition yourself. And you require a break. You require a break and you require a complete independence in this case. That will be the biggest challenge. And of course, all the other challenges, that is, when you go for career transitioning, at least in the male, it is a very, very difficult proposition at this present age because most of the people, you will have to cope over three problems. First is changing your skills and acquiring new skills when the conditions are not going to be very good. Second is an onslaught of the people who will keep on saying that is now this person is finished, he's worth nothing at all, and that he is a gone case. He is doomed completely. Now you will have to listen to those things as well. And within it, you have to maintain your semblance of equality, maintain your semblance of thinking, perception balance to move ahead. And you will always have to be very strong when you are going to be at your weakest. That is the biggest challenge in this case.
Perfectly fine, sir. Normally we say that we do better, we do good when our mindset is secure, but we do better when it is insecure. How to make a balance? There is a fine line between security and insecurity. How to make a balance between the security and insecurity?
Security is not something that is associated with outside world. Security is something that is associated with how is it that you can go to tide over your own issues or your own problems. Maybe in some cases you require to be passionate and you think that once being passionate has been enough of a time, you don't require to be passionate, you become balanced. When you think that now balance is going to be so much of it, then what you're going to do is that you go on to become very practical and techno-savvy. And when you're fed up with the technology, then you say, no, it's better to be ascetic and being in the mountains itself. Now, this is where if you have this type of a capability of two things, self-understanding, ability to tide over your problems, and ability to reinvent yourself, responsible external milieu, the external circumstances, external environment, or independently as well, that means self-guided as well, you will continue to be secure. And the moment you're going to see it as a problem, then that is always going to be a problem. As we're going to say, then when mind is weak, every situation is a problem. When mind is balanced, every situation is a challenge. When mind is strong, every problem is an opportunity. So you have to make your mind strong.
Right. So now I'm taking up a few questions. Is it possible for everyone to have a job? The resources of the earth are limited. So the solutions lay in sharing of resources and preventing accumulation of wealth in few hands.
See, this is a Western narrative, getting everyone having a job. Now, job is, that means if you are working, if you're working for yourself, you're working for the betterment of your own personality, always trying to self-improve, you have a job in hand. And that's the biggest job, best job that you can go to think of. Not that you have to get yourself employed in someone's company or in someone's organization to get it. That's number one. That is the concept of job, and that will be the concept of the job in the coming days. Well, us resources are limited, so will be the, but the avenues will not be. If that is a problem, I gave you a hint. If that is a problem, now if you think that the earth's resources are limited, use this problem, create an opportunity, and start recycling those resources. Use this opportunity, use this as an opportunity, and then start setting a different type of paradigm on resource management. So you're going to be having another job in your hand that way. Now use this as an opportunity also to see this as a problem. And then after having looked at it, you start galvanizing good number of people so that people don't use these resources to the detriment of Mother Earth and don't degrade the environment. You start preserving the environment, you start protecting it, and you have a job in hand. Now, what are you talking about? All of those people, you have a job and job as long as you are able to reform yourself and as long as you're able to move ahead without any type of an effect on the Mother Planet.
Right, sir. So now the next question is, should a person's worth be measured by what job he has or whether he has one? Should this change?
See, when this question is going to be about should, then everything can go on to be very hypothetical. I only going to say one of these things. Should be, that means the government should be responsive. The government should be very good. The government should be very caring. The medicine should not harm the person. Now, the doctor should be very, very good to talk to. Now, should means that it's prescriptive approach, and you, the moment you're going to apply it to anything, then it goes on to become very, very hypothetical. What we're going to say is that we are moving towards a gig economy. Now, gig economy means where everyone will be a brand. Everyone will be having an identity. Everyone will go to wear a separate identity. Everyone will go on to become a personality for themselves. Everyone will go to have a niche type of a skill. And it is this skill, it is this personality, it is this identity. And how is it that they're going to manage it will go on to propel their career. That is what is India is going to be in the next 5-10, if not 5 years, definitely 10 years later on, we're going to enter into a gig economy where you're going to be having everything in your house. You don't have to go to your office. You're going to enjoy your stay in your house. Keep on working, whatever type that you can go to work. But you will be a brand in yourself. You will going to provide services to 20 companies. And all of these 20 companies will be very, very happy with you. And even if they're going to sever your ties with them, that will be very, very institutionalized also. That is the type of economy that we are going to be moving towards, Punitji, in the coming years. So there is no way that we're going to be having a scope of anything called as a job. Job is something where you're going to become an employee of someone. That is what is synonymous to being a job. And where you're going to become a servant to someone. Why is it not that you can go on to think of creating your own identity, creating your own brand, creating a niche brand of yourself, develop a skill that no one goes on to be having it, because this is what exactly the future will go to require. And that is where we are moving towards it. You take a look at national education policy, it is pointing towards it. You take a look at the space policy, that is, you can go on to, you can be a small rocket manufacturer, you can be a small satellite manufacturer, and still you can go on to earn billions of dollars. Earning will not go on to be only in terms of money. Earning will then go on to be in terms of your terms of what you want to say is respectability, in terms of your branding, popularity, reach, amount of a trust that you people can go to repose on you. Earning will not only and merely be in terms of money. Anyone who goes on to think that they're going to earn money and they're going to get a job, their future is doomed in this case.
So the idea of a single or a long-lasting career is no more. It's a matter of
it will not going to last. It will go on to be there, but all of those people will be only laggards. That means they will go on to move. They will go on to get themselves on the floor, and there will be a lot of such type of people. Of course, when there are going to be a lot of gig economy workers who will going to be independent, they will require services of a good number of people who will be doing their job, menial job of sorts. That will always be going to be there. But you see, it's their choice whether you want to be job or not. But then such type of a job, for example, you're going to be having one job. where you actually go to create an identity for yourself, where you actually develop the skill to such an extent that you are recognized by you. The company is recognized by you. The organization is recognized by you. The entire institution is recognized by you. That is going to be one part of it. Take the case of Indian movies. Indian movies, not too many people going to know the directors. Sometime back, that they used to be known by directors. Now the Indian movies are going to be known by the actors. Now that is the type of transition that has taken place. Of course, it is again going to be moving back towards the storyline of the film, the direction of the film, the location in which it has been shot, and things like that. But then that part of a film being identified by an actor or an actress always goes on to remain. That's the change that has taken place.
So one micro question is there. Why would an employer hire you when you are looking for a transition?
Because you are always going to be best. You're always going to give your best. You'll always go on to look for the benefit of the company. I'm going to hire someone because I know that even that the person is going to be very creative, very passionate. He is complete maverick. But in 4 years, he can go to completely transform me, my company, my work, and my entire situation. He will go to move, but he will not go to ditch. He will go to move ahead, but then he will go to move ahead by benefiting me. The 4 years of relationship that he's going to build, I'll remember it for a lifetime. That is why I'm going to employ someone. And that is why someone will go to employ someone as well.
So basic phenomena is if you're thinking for others. So that philosophy should be the first step. Then you are having some unique solution for the problem or the scarcity or the growth for other. Definitely, you are employable. You are a fittest or suitable person to get employed.
That is what we are talking about, Purichi, because we are talking about a fusion of that is the coming years. We are not talking about what is happening right now. We are talking about what will going to happen after 5 to 10 years of time, maybe 10 years of time. And if you are, let's say, 21 years of age right now, 25 years of age, obviously you are looking to build your career when you are going to be at 40 years. And at 40 years, if you're going to start thinking about right now, you may not be able to plan for it. But the moment you're going to have a reverse planning, the moment you're going to design your thinking to take advantage of the next 5-10 years of a time, you'll be in a much, much, much better position completely.
Right. You coined this term, a relationship. Usually what people perceive that when it comes to employee or employer relationship, it is just give and take relationship. I pay you for some solution and you execute that solution. But in the coming time, is it going to be more crucial or it's going to be changed?
Both ways. It is going to be both ways. But then it's actually going to be more transactional. That means you give a service, you take it because no one is there to build a relationship. But the moment you are able to build a relationship, you're going to think of it. I have 50 people working for me, but there are 2 people who have built a relationship with me and I go on to be falling for them. I will go on to do anything for them to keep them in the company, to keep them in the situation, to keep them in the organization. And because I'll have so much amount of a trust. Trust not only on their ability, but also on their attitude. Ability will go on to matter only to a certain extent. More than that is going to be the attitude associated with it. That means values and sincerity will going to count much more than that of talent alone. In any case, values and sincerities are the one with the people who go on to last with you. Talented person may be completely valueless person, and you may be having a very bright chemical engineer, but then someone spoils his mind, he goes into become a terrorist, he starts making a bomb out of it. That is a possibility. So initially with everyone, it is going to be transactional, but then you are a human being. You are not meant to be acting like a robot at all. Just be humane in that place, just be human. And you don't have to think of harming anyone and deliberately harming anyone at all. You will go on to rule it because that is a new type of a brand that you're going to be building for yourself. Why is it that you have to be robot-faced and poker-faced and mechanical in your working in this case at all? Having that quality is going to be good. Do it, but at the same time, do in a humane manner.
Right. So we have another query. Companies have a function keeping the social objectives. as its goals. A company cannot have a goal of its own. What's your view?
Company can go to have a goal of its own. That is, why not? I mean, company's goal is not only if a company goes on to think that I'm going to earn money, 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 and money, then money does not going to last ever with anyone. I mean, ask Anil Ambani, he will go to tell you much better than what I am going to be telling you right now. Chase vision. Don't chase money. Money will end up following you. Chase respectability. Chase brand. Money, job, and identity will end up following you. That will be the future.
Absolutely right. So in the coming time when technology is overpowering everything, and at the beginning you said that we need human, not robots. So when everything is artificial intelligence, so how to keep your natural intelligence intact? It's a big challenge because we see this, Atal Tinkering Labs, so much of technology has started even at school level. So, how to keep that imagination alive, simultaneously using technological aids as well?
Artificial intelligence will go to ease our job. Artificial intelligence will go to simplify some of those things. Artificial intelligence cannot go to define that we are feeling hungry, we are feeling emotive, we are feeling affectionate, we want to build social capital, and the scene doesn't going to help me, or the scene I don't going to like it. Artificial intelligence is not going to help you where you have to build relationship with heart. Human beings are different from all the people because they not only go on to think like robots, they don't go on to have a defined process of coming to a logic. They can be intuitive as well. And when you go on to perceive certain things, one external milieu, one external stimuli, one variable can go on to change your entire perception with respect to that. It's like that is a I go on to meet you, and in the first instance, I go on to fall for you. I go on to fall in affection with you. I go on to have a liking for you. How is it that artificial intelligence can go on to be significant in this case? This is something that is innate, that is completely human. Of course, when I go on to be having a mobile, I want to learn something, I go on to specify a feat, some of my choices, my life will go on to become easy. Maybe that I'm aided. So what the role will be that some of those things that my drivers used to do, maybe my servants used to do, maybe my helpers used to do, artificial intelligence will be able to do that. But then we have to become more human being. And unless we're going to, we cannot go on to utilize the next challenges that we are going to be coming up or erupting in the 21st century.
If you can suggest the sectors where growth is bound to happen in the coming 5 years time or 10 years time, specific sectors.
there are four sectors that I'm going to think that are going to be very significant. The first is going to be, at least in India, coming to India, the first is going to be education sector. This is largely because we are talking about education, we are not talking about literacy. We are talking about a complete overhaul of the way in which students are taught values, taught sincerity, taught simplification of those things. That's number one. Second is the health sector. We require to go through minimalistic living standards. Minimalistic living, that means how is it that in minimum amount of money, in minimum amount of expenditure, we can go to make a living, we can go to live also. Because a consumerist society is not going to be helping us in this case at all. And anything wrong that goes on to go with the health of, let's say, any person. Now COVID has taught us a lesson. We cannot going to survive. This is the second part. The third is going to be a set with agriculture. Agriculture is going to be the in thing for the whole of the country. And then we're going to have a variety of type of agriculture, sustainable agriculture, organic agriculture. Then one of them is mass agriculture, niche agriculture, and so on and so forth. Agriculture and agriculture, horticulture, and tourism, both of them will be linked. You will go to have tourism like health tourism, educational tourism, physic tourism. Now that is going to be the fourth part associated with it, where you can go to leave yourself into nature, into an agriculture field, into a resort where you can go to cook your own food, cultivate your own crops in that place, away through the fields in this place, be with nature, and that will go on to help you to an extent. Now, other than these four sectors, you, of course, the other sectors that are going to be opening up is going to be in space science, largely because we are moving, going to be erupting in space and trying to take colonize this. Artificial intelligence and space going to be both linked to it. Artificial intelligence is going to be another planet where there will be a lot of changes that will be required. But I do not going to think that we are going to move towards a consumerist society. So industries, a lot of manufacturing industries will not going to survive. We're going to have only two sectors that will be very, very well developed. One, natural and nature associated with the glocalization. And another will be artificial intelligence, which will not require to degrade the environment, which will not be associated with the deleterious effect on the environment of the actions that we're going to see. So that because we want to be happy, in the coming years, we want to be happy. And there is only three ways in which you can be happy. One, being with the people that we like to be with, number one. Second is eating and having a lifestyle that is not going to make us sick. And third is easing our job to such an extent that all of those things that have been made, that have been assisted to us by the servants, drivers, and all of those with the help of artificial intelligence.
Vikasji, may I request you if you wish to ask some questions?
Siddharthaji, I just wanted to ask. I remember that when we were there, they used to say, if you choose a goal and continue to do that. But nowadays, like you also said, that one has to be driven by passion. Sometimes because of peer pressures, parents' pressure, one chooses a profession, or sometimes one feels that one who has chosen that particular passion, actually it is not driving him the way it should be. A very good friend of mine we have out here, Kashish Mittal, he stood around third in the IIT, he stood fourth in the IAS, but he had a passion for classical singing. He left that civil services last year and is doing in this civil service. How do you feel that actually one should stick to that particular plan, what plan A was taken, or one should leave that profession and feel and take a leap forward for the profession or the passion with which one is living for? Like someone has an artistic feeling within his mind and suddenly he has chosen some other profession, but he feels no, as an artist, I would have done better. And he starts taking passion. I know a doctor who had his entire family was into the they were into the artist backgrounds, they were murals, etc. So he left that passion for the of doctor to take up his passion. So what is your call? One should keep on sticking to that, or there will be a lot of changing within the profession within 5 years, 10 years, just like what we used to say in our old times, that this bed is so old and so strong that the entire generations can prevail. Nowadays, even the children will say, it may be strong, but we have to change with the changing times.
You have to change. This is what we talked about, career transitioning. You may have taken some of your friends that you talked about, they may have been very, very talented, possible. So they talked in IIT, they talked in the civil services, but then their heart was somewhere else. If you follow your heart, you will always be able to build your career. Not necessarily that when you're going to become completely mechanical, you will go to do it. Because following your heart, and following your heart means that you develop a lot of insight, because you keep on thinking. The amount of investment that you're going to do in your thinking, being passionate about something, doesn't come when you're going to become completely mechanical. I have to do a job, I have to be at my office at 9 o'clock and come back at 5 o'clock, then go on for a regulatory dinner or so on Fridays or on Saturdays and so on. Passionate means that you are happy. Passionate means that you understand yourself. Passionate means that you are able to diversify. Passionate means that you can go on to do as much amount of labor as no one can go to imagine, because when passion drives you, then there's nothing called as hard labor. All the work that you're going to do, that becomes fun. And when work becomes fun, why is it that you have to work at all? The world is replete with examples that only those people have been supra successful. Only those people who have been ultra successful who have followed their heart. It is the heart that drives you. And it is this drive that takes you to all of those places where normal people cannot go on to go at all. If you have a passion for paleogeography and you're going to do that, and you're going to practice paleogeography, you will be a world beater. If you are actually going to, you can go to take examples. Someone like Raju Srivastava, who was doing nothing, he was a buffoon of sorts, almost. I'm making a mockery of good number of people. He made a career out of it because he was passionate. Now, who goes to talk about the management and other skills in this case? He has built a career. And you also know that there are going to be good number of people who have been mocking people and they have made a career like billions in this case, only because they're passionate about it. You're going to find that without passion, you cannot go to be a cricketer. You cannot go to be a cricketer because you want to be a cricketer. You want, because cricket is your passion. Cricket lives in your veins. Cricket is what exactly that makes you think. You live, you eat, you drink, you sleep, and you die cricket. Only then you can go to become a cricketer. Otherwise not. So there is no substitute for passion in this case, Vikasi, at all. We have a passion, you have a career. Not that you're going to pick up a profession. This is going to be my profession. I'm fond of mathematics and I'm going to become a lawyer. What exactly will I going to do? Natural instinct of a lawyer is an impromptu reply. If I don't going to be having that impromptu reply, how is it that I'm going to build a career in this case at all?
Right, sir.
So one question has come. It says, is it really possible to pursue your passion? Your passion may not be able to make you earn that money what you actually think and desire.
But we are talking about career. Career is not associated with money. Career is associated with your brand. Career is associated with your identity. Career is associated with your perception. Career is associated with your happiness. Career is a respectability that you've earned. What you're talking about is money. Money has nothing to do with career. Money has to do with if you are very transactional, then you will go on to substitute even your respectability for earning money. This is no career at all. How is it that money can go on to help you tide over a crisis that is going to be moral in nature? How is it so many of these people who have made careers out of airlines see where they are completely bankrupt? Because external circumstances are not in your favor. When you have a passion, you can tide over any type of a circumstance, external, internal, or any one of them. You will go on to believe that our president may not be having good amount of money, but then is it not that he has a brand that no one can go to match it? Is it not the same goes on to go for our prime minister as well? Is it that he has earned money? No. Is it not that some of the people who have earned money, they are leaving it. They are leaving money. They are allowing this money to be drained because they want to make some amount of difference. Leadership is all about creating a legacy. Leadership is all about creating many leaders like you. Leadership is all about changing the society. Leadership is all about bringing people into fold so that they start the thinking new. Now, this is what is going to be passion. This is what is going to be career. Career cannot going to be that you're going to become, you're going to find a job with someone in some company, start earning money, and then drive a Mercedes-Benz. People who may not be going to be driving Mercedes-Benz, they may be driving cycles, but they will be having a career. They will be having a passion. They'll be having satisfaction, and they'll be having a reach, access, and a satisfaction of happiness as well. That is career.
Right. So it's about building your own identity. At the end of the day, what we need, 6x4 bed and 2 chapatis and very basic things are needed. And might be in the beginning, it is charming to have dinners at 5 stars or having lavish lifestyle. But might be after 5-10 years, you get bored with that, all that.
I slightly intervene, Puniji, here. I'm going to say you're going to find no less than some 30 people who are someone from Harvard, someone from Stanford, someone who going to be from MIT. They have come back to India. They have left something like 6-7 crore rupees of a package. And what they're doing in a rural area, they are either transforming the people in the rural areas or they're teaching children in that place. Yeah? Or they're thinking about a change in the lifestyle of the people. Now, it's not about money in this case at all, because they don't want to see themselves in that place at all. One can go to have all the type of maybe Lamborghinis and Ferraris with them and 7-star hotels, Hiltons and all of these. But it may not going to charm you, because everything ultimately goes on to translate into, even in that condition, if you don't go to feel peace, then there is no way that you can go to be happy at all. And this one statement or one Sanskrit shloka that I going to be having it, that is, vichara param jnanam shamohi param sukham. That is, the greatest knowledge in the world is curiosity. You may be having a lot of books, but you're not curious. I mean, this is no knowledge at all. And Shamohi Param Sukham, that is, peace is the greatest luxury, right? If you go to have all the luxuries, but you don't go to be having peace, what career can you go to talk of? Money will go on to buy you a girl. Money will not go on to buy you the love of that girl. Money may go on to give you a house. Money will not go on to give you a home. Money may go on to give you access to doctors. Money will not go on to give you health.
Rightly said. When it comes to plan something, either we do less or sometimes we do more, or sometimes we get stuck up with the planning only and we are poor when it comes to execution. So what is your piece of advice on do's and don'ts about planning and then execution?
See, poverty is a state of mind. You will go on to find that there'll be two group of people, one who will be having his hands, legs, all right, and he will go to do labor, he will go to earn for himself. The second person, what he will go to do is that he'll go to sit and beg. That's a state of mind. It's like when you want to blame some people, that's a state of mind. When you want to tide over this crisis, that is a state of mind. When you go on to improve yourself constantly and you are in a state of constant improvement, then that is a state of mind. And when you go on to think that you cannot go on to improve at all because you are in such a condition, pitiable condition, maybe in a bad condition, then of course that is also a state of mind. Now some do's and don'ts for all of those people who want to forge ahead, going ahead, money is essential. There is no doubt about it, absolutely. Essential to what extent? Essential in the sense that we're going to give you respectability. That is, you don't have to spread your hands in front of someone. That much amount of money is essential that you don't have to. But then you can go on to have a watch that will go on to give you correct time for 300 rupees as well. It can be for 3 crore rupees as well, depending on whether it is going to be Britling or depending on whether it is going to be some brand of Titan which you want to gift it to your children as well. So one of these don'ts is don't go on to be over ambitious. Over ambitious means that is there is a limit to all that everyone can go to do. I'm very fond of cricket, but if I want to think now that I will go to become a fast bowler, I can't become. So of course, for me, the don't is I don't want to dream of it, right? I have been playing some amount of drum, but I have left it. I don't intend to pick it up once again because I know that I cannot practice it because the amount of time that it requires will be different. So the biggest do will be that go for self-understanding. You are the best judge to know what is going to be good for you, what you can go on to do, what you cannot go on to not do. You cannot go to discount. You can't go to discount external circumstances. External circumstances, when they're going to hit you, they're always going to hit you completely. There's no way that you can go to escape from that. But ultimately, with respect to this question, there is something in Sanskrit that I will go on to talk of, which goes on to be equally good for everyone. There are 4 things that go on to determine you. Prarabdh, all the work that you're going to do, every work that you're going to do, the more you're going to improve, the more you define your ability, the more it comes back to you. That is one. And anything that you have gone to do something in the past, that means in this year, that will also going to come to you. Purusharth is how much as you can go on to do it. That is, keep on doing it, irrespective of the condition, irrespective of the situation in this case. That is, you keep on doing it. And when you are having a bad time, then what you have to do is that improve your ability so that you keep on waiting for an opportunity to strike you so that you can go to convert into luck. That's the second part. The third is Kal. Kal is time. That means you cannot go on to predict it at all. And when it goes on to strike you, even the richest of the person can go on to be floored, lying flat on the floor. It can go on to demolish you at any point of time. One small incident and that can go on to ruin you forever. And the last part is Ashish, that is Ashirvad, that is the blessings. When blessings go on to work, anything can go on to do wonders for you. And at any point of do, it can go on to do so much amount of wonder, you can't imagine it also. So that's the best do's and don'ts that I can go to think of, at least in this present term. But otherwise, in more empirical terms, for the youth, the do's will be, that is, improve your communication, improve your perception balance. Don't be a cheater. Don't go on to think of a short term at all in this case. use technology, but not at the expense of the people in this case. Yeah, and always go on to have a reverse planning. Reverse planning, that means, how do you want to see yourself from the place where you want to see after 15, 20 years of time. Don'ts will be, in some of these conditions, you don't have to be a liar at all. Because the moment you're going to do anything bad, you are living in a world of social media where everything will start following you. You have to be compulsively honest. You can't afford to be dishonest in this case. Because let's say you have been dishonest with a person after being with a person for 2 years of time and being very, very close. You have lost the amount of investment that you have made for 2 years of time. Don't be dishonest. That is the biggest don't. Because most of the youth are going to do that part. And they're going to do it very, very religiously as well. The other is, don't go on to be a short-term thinker at all. Short-term thinking doesn't go on to take you anywhere at all. And it is not that you're going to become very smart. Smartness doesn't go on to mean that you have to be cunning. Being smart doesn't mean that you have to be cunning. And when you are cunning, then only you are going to find super cunning people who are going to rule over you, right? So that is another part that you have to shed. And try to make your life as simple as possible. And that will be saving you a lot of money. That will be giving you a lot of relationship, and that will also go on to make other people invest their thinking in you. And if, let's say, if I start investing my thinking in, let's say, anyone, then I keep on finding an opportunity to help him and to help the other person. The opportunities will go on to multiply in this case. That is the world that we are living in. And that is the world we have to live in. Whatever that we are, in whichever manner that we are living right now, that is not sustainable. That will not last. You have to learn from that. And this is what we have learned.
Each interaction with you teaches new and a lot many things, sir. Definitely a lot many keywords as well as the thinking process. I mean, I have taken a lot many things from you today. I'm sure the beneficiaries, those watching through this live session as well as Facebook and YouTube and the coming time, the YouTube as well. They will also get benefited by the teachings of Dr. K. Siddharth, sir. And this is all for today from my side. Over to, with lots of thanks to Siddharth ji and Vikas ji for this ongoing journey by your vision, mission and passion as well. Over to Vikas ji.
Thank you, Puneet.
After the entire insights having been given by Dr. K. Siddhartha, I'm reminded what we used to be taught in the basics, that if wealth is lost, nothing is lost. If health is lost, something is lost. But if character is lost, everything is lost. So the entire crux, what I can gather is that what Dr. Siddhartha said, that we should lay a lot of emphasis on our character. Because they say the characters of a personal human being shows the character of the nation. So we have to develop in such a way that the character of the entire nation is looked upon for all values, moral values, social values, economic values, so that we can be a strong force to reckon with. It's not that we are not at all today. But as Dr. Siddhartha said, we have to relook ourselves and then re-examine ourselves as to what could be the shortcomings and how we can move forward. I, on behalf of the entire team of Beyond Law, the participants watching us on the Facebook and on this platform, we are glad to learn the lessons, which would, I'm quite sure people would be taking things forward and they have a food for thought as to how they can progress further. And tomorrow's webinar would be Test Identification Parade under the CRPC, the nuances of that by Justice A.V. Chandrasekhar, a former judge of Kerala High Court. Has already two webinars on our platform have been a huge success. Do stay connected with us at 5 p.m. And thank you, Dr. K. Siddhartha and Professor Unisha, for an insightful session.
Thank you so much.
Not only good for the participants, but for at least for me. there are a lot of things which I could learn. Thank you, everyone. Stay safe, stay blessed. Jai Hind.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.